Hello, my name is Casie. I'm a gymnastics coach and fitness trainer, and I'm going to teach you a basic beginner level gymnastics warm-up. So join me, meet me up on your feet. We're gonna start jogging. Here we go, right arm circles backwards. You can do this around if you have space, or you can do it in place. We're just jogging, one arm circle backwards. Put your other hand on your hip if you want, or just leave it down. But this arm that's moving should be straight and forward. Very nice, very nice. And switch, other arm backwards. Can it pass by your ear on the way up and over? And forward. So, from the side, chopping looks like this, and crisscross, and skipping. So in gymnastics, it's all about form. Point that toe down at the floor when you explode off of it. Arms are straight. High knees. So think your hands are going ear to pocket. Get those knees up. And back to kick. Again, hands are going ear to pocket. Nice. All right, doing our releve walks. Arms are up. Squeezing through your ears. Fingers are in crowns, what we call crown. Because our fingers come out like a shoulder crown. We'll come close. Here's what your fingers are doing. Okay? Up and over your head. Alright, squeeze your knees. Don't let them bend. Go up on your tippy toes, releve. And walk forward. And walk backwards. Don't let those knees bend.
Up, scoot your feet out just
a little bit further in front of you to make a diamond shape. Put your arms under the bottom of your legs, around your ankles, and pull your forehead to your heels for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Awesome. All right, sit in your pike position. Legs are together. Feet are straight out in front of you. Look to the side so you can see a little bit better. Point your feet. When we say point your feet in gymnastics, that means your whole foot from your toes to your heel. It's not just your toes stretching together, but your ankles. So we're pointing our whole feet. Our knees stay straight. For these next few stretches, I only want you to reach as far forward as you can while maintaining a straight knee. So if your knees start to bend, that means you've reached too far forward for yourself, and just straighten them out, come up a little bit, and maintain that form. Okay, so reach up, point your toes, flex them, that's the opposite of pointing. Point, flex. Can you flex so hard that your heels lift off the floor? Point one and flex one. Switch. Switch. Point both of them. Reach up. And fall forward. Again, only reaching as far forward as you can. Keeping these knees straight. These boys ain't shit. Inhale. Exhale. Go further into the stretch. Try to keep that back nice and flat. If this is easy for you, try to get your elbows to the floor. Nice, and come up. Flex those feet. And reach forward again with a flat back. If you can reach your feet, can you pull them off the floor? If you can do that, it's easy. You can get your elbows toward your knees. These boys breathe into the stretch. I'm not here for it. If you want me, great. Let's do our shoulder stretch. So your fingers point away from your butt, behind your back. If you can, touch your pinkies together. Good. But your fingers are pointing away from your butt, behind you. Arms stay so straight for this. Slide your bottom forward. Your hands stay where they are. Arms are straight. Further. You want to practice your shaping. You can try your tuck. Knees come up. Your pike. Straight knees, pointed feet. Legs are together. Your straddle. Knees are straight. Toes are pointed. Rolling your knees backwards. Again, tuck. Pike. Straddle. Alright. Speaking of straddles, we're going to sit in our straddle. So, feet come out to the side. Knees are straight. You don't want to make mountains with your knees. Keep them straight. Keep your toes pointed. Head side forward. Arms come up and over for 10, 9. Roll your knees back. 8. Keep your toes pointed. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Little big arms in T. Other side for 10, 9, roll your knees back, 8, don't want to come forward, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and come back for that second that I left out there, arms are in T. Okay, we're going to roll forward. I need you to make sure that your knees don't roll forward and your toes don't roll forward with your upper body. They stay back up to the ceiling. So hands come in front. And stretch as far forward as you can go, keeping those knees and toes back, not letting them roll forward. How far forward can you reach? If you can go all the way, your arms can come out to the side and your feet can go on the floor for 10, 9, straight knees, roll them back, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, two, and one. Come up. Excellent job. Sit in your crisscross applesauce or a kneel, whichever is more comfortable for you. Reach one arm over, scoop it up. Keep the arm that's straight, straight. And look over your shoulder. Give it a big hug. Inhale, exhale. And switch sides. Scoop, look over your shoulder. Keep this arm straight. Inhale and exhale. We don't often talk about breathing very much in gymnastics, but it is a goal of mine because it helps so much. We exhale on the hard part when we go deeper into the stretch. And behind your head, reach over, pat yourself on the back, grab that elbow, and pull gently. We're not trying to rip our shoulder off here. And switch, reach over, grab that elbow. Stretch our wrists out here. So, fingers are facing forward. Go up on your hands and knees. Let's practice a pelvic tilt, which means your pelvis is tucked under. You're not pushing your butt out. So we're on our hands and knees. Your pelvis is tucked. You're not arching your back like this. Tuck it. Fingers facing forward. Rock forward and back. If you have the tendency to hyperextend your elbow, that means when it bends backwards like this, you can put a slight bend in your elbows with these stretches, for all of these wrist stretches. And flip your hands upside down, fingers are facing your knees. Again, put a slight bend in those elbows. If you are someone who can hyperextend them, maybe you've been told you're double jointed in your elbows, you don't want to hyperextend here in gymnastics. So rock forward and back. And gently, flip upside down, put them down super gently. We're not putting a lot of pressure here. Rock forward and back. Hands out. Rock side to side. Side to side again. You might need to put a little bend in your elbows. And one more time, fingers at the top. In a circular motion to one side. And switch, go the other way in your circular motion. Awesome, roll your wrists out. I call this making a meatball. Make your meatball, roll your wrists out, go both directions if you can. And I call this making spaghetti, if you want to try it. Reach out, show me those palms. Fingers are laced, reach up. Practicing squeezing your arms to your ears with straight elbows. And reach to one side without falling over. And the other side. Feel that stretch down in here. Seems like you could use a little. And lower your arms. Great. All right, we're gonna stretch our Achilles out, so meet me up. In gymnastics, sometimes we call this a mountain, so it's kind of a downward dog. Fingers are spread, elbows are straight, we're up in the air. Let's start by pedaling those feet, trying to get those heels to the floor. It's okay if your heels do not go all the way to the floor, but practice with straight legs, as getting them as far down as you can, keeping those legs super straight. Back. And push one to the floor, stretching that Achilles, and switch sides, and both. Press those toes under. We call this a seal stretch in gymnastics. Your toes are together, your legs are squeezed. Push up and look at the ceiling. Nice. And a cat stretch. We come back. We're not sitting all the way on our heels for this. Your booty goes up in the air and your arms go as far forward as you can. Try to get those armpits to the floor. Keep your arms straight. And child's pose, sit all the way back on your heels. Fingers are alive in front of you. Going up to the floor. Take a few breaths here. Okay, moving into splits. So we're gonna stretch our legs out before we start doing our splits. I personally like to start with my bad leg so it's done and it's out of the way. So I'm gonna take my bad leg, which happens to be my right leg. I'm gonna put it in front. And we're gonna lean forward into a forward lunge. You wanna make sure that your knee does not do this, does not go in front of your toe. Instead, you wanna slide that foot far out in front of you and lean into it. Your knee stays behind your toe. It's in line with my toe. I could draw a straight line here, but it's not going in front of it. Same with my back leg. My hips stay forward this whole time. And I'm leaning into it here. Keep that back foot tucked under. You don't want your toe up like this. It's tucked under. All right, meet me in this position. I'm up on this leg. My front leg is straight now and I'm flexing my front foot. You're gonna try to get your nose to your knee. Keep that flex in the knee straight. Position here. You're gonna pull your back foot up to your butt. You can help yourself by keeping a hand on the floor or maybe leaning on your front leg. But try to get this back foot all the way up to your butt. If you want to try, you can try with both hands, balancing, and leaning forward for a challenge. Check in with that front knee. Is it still behind your toe? All right, we're gonna slide into our split. So one hand on each side, hips stay forward the whole time. I'll come to the front. Hips stay forward the whole time. Push your feet further apart from each other and you're in your split. Focus on keeping this front knee straight, your front toe pointed, and both hands on the floor, one hand on each side. Hips to the front, so we're not like this. Right? Our hips are not like this, we're not like this. This isn't a split, this is just hanging out. So hips to the front. I think you've been in it for 10 seconds. By now, you can roll your back leg around to the front. And let's do the other side, good job. So now this is my better leg. I'll do this one to the front so you can see a front view. Put your front foot, put your other foot out in front. Put it far out in front of you and lean forward into this stretch. Again, remember that your knee does not come in front of that front foot. Instead, your foot is in front of your knee, but they are in line with each other. And lean into it. And back. So we're in this position now. Our front leg is straight. Back leg is bent, front foot is flexed. That makes it extra tricky. Try to get your nose to your knee by keeping the knee straight and your front foot flexed. And bring your back foot up to your butt. Balance. Again, keeping those hips straight forward. We're not leaning to the side. Hips to the front, even if that means you have to balance yourself with your hands. Or maybe it's on your front foot. Front knee, rather. Pulling that back foot up to your butt. If you can for a challenge, lean forward a little bit. And slide into your split again. Your front leg is straight, your front toe is pointed, your hips are straight to the front, one hand on each side. We're not leaning to either side. Keep that knee straight. Your back knee, let's talk about that. Your back knee should be feet tucked under on the floor, as well as your toe. You don't want your leg out to the side in a diagonal, so look behind you and see, is my leg in a straight line behind me? Is my hips forward? Come on, out. All right, our middle split, some people call it a straddle split. I like to stretch it out before I go. So I'm in a sumo squat position, my hands go on my knees, thumbs to the front, and I just push my knees apart, push my shoulders in and down. And switch sides. And both in the middle, pushing those knees apart and down. Okay, for our middle split, you don't want your knees on the floor, and I personally prefer a flexed foot with your toes going back because it helps stretch even more. Hands go down on the front in front of you. Slide those feet apart. I, like I said, personally flex my feet, gives me a better stretch. Knees stay straight. If this is easy for you, you can go down on your elbows. And come out. Shake them out. Well done on those splits. Okay, we're gonna practice a candlestick position. This is an important position in gymnastics, especially helps us on bars. So first things first, you're gonna lay on your back in a straight body position, knees together, pointed toes, arms down by your side. We're gonna go through the sequence for this. So the first thing is a rock and roll. Bring your knees to your belly. Rock and roll, see if you can sit up without using your hands. Your hands are just on your legs, or you can squeeze your knees like this. So from the front, like this. Or this. Awesome, that is a rock and roll. So, from the side, now we're gonna extend our legs straight up in the air. From a rock and roll. So rock back, put your hands under your hips, and bring your toes up to the ceiling. This is a candlestick position. You want your toes straight up to the ceiling, not going toward your back wall. This is cheating. It makes it easier for you to bring your hands down, but it's cheating. You want your toes to be straight up to the ceiling here. Once you've got this in the right place, then you can practice bringing your arms down and holding it here. Once you can do that, you can do your candlestick with your arms above your head, but it's so tricky. Lean back, candlestick up. And come down. Let's try that one more time. Wherever you are in that sequence, we're gonna hold for 5 seconds. I'll go through the different arm sequences again. Hands on your hips to start. Once you've got that with good form, hands down by your side. Once you've got that with good form, hands up above your head. I'm going to do hands on my hips for the beginner level. Okay, here we go. Roll back to candlestick, feet come up, straight above your head, not going toward the back wall. Straight up for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, roll down. Very nice, friends, lay on your back. You have two options here. You can do a tabletop, which is when your hands are next to your bottom, out on the side, your feet come up, and you push your belly to the ceiling. You look like a table. So you can do that again, feet come up, hands by your bottom, push up, belly to the ceiling. That is a tabletop. You could choose that option, or you can lay on your back, bring your feet up to the same position as tabletop. Fingers go next to your ears, thumbs are next to your ears, elbows to the ceiling. We're gonna push up into a bridge in yoga. This is called a mule. Push up and lean through your armpits. Excellent form is when our knees are straight, our feet are together, and our knees are together. Arms pushing straight. Look at your belly button and come down. Rock and roll 3 times. 1, 2, 3. Great. It's really important to look at your belly button or your chest before you come down so you don't hurt your head or your neck when you come down. We're gonna do that one more time. Choose the option that's best for you today, either your tabletop or your bridge. See which one you can do with the best form. Okay, hand your back or sit if you're doing your tabletop. Feet ready, knees together. Flatten the floor, don't ever go on tippy toes for these. You need to keep your heels flat on the floor. Arms up, thumbs next to your ears, elbows to the ceiling, and push up. For five, four, three, flat heels, two, and one, lift your belly button. Come down, rock and roll three times. One, two, three. Okay, the last thing we will do in our warm-up is rock and roll and see if you can stand up without using your hands. So your hands in front the whole time. Let's try three rock and rolls, and on the third one, we'll stand up. Here we go. One, two. We're gonna stand up on this one. Three, stand up without using your hands. Awesome, let's try that one more time. Taking away two of the rock and rolls, so we're doing one and standing up right away. See if you can do it from standing to begin with. Here's one rock and roll to stand up. Here we go. Rock and roll. And stand up without using your hands. Nice job, friends. Hope you enjoyed this gymnastics-inspired warm-up. Let me know if you have any questions or things you want to talk about.